Hello and welcome to another update of my model railway Gronkston. This is my delayed Christmas present that eventually arrived, and I paid for it, so it's out of my own cash. It's a Heljan Class 33. It has a chip fitted. The windows, which you can see look a bit odd, that's actually got masking solution on it, because I shall be weathering that in the next couple of months. So that's the new addition to the layout on the railway side. If we zoom out, work hasn't been going much in the way of the scenic side, apart from on the second board, which I'll show you in a second. But in the background on board one, we've added the control station. This is all made out of architectural board. It is not ideal for exhibition purposes in its current state. I shall be fitting some plywood underneath the full length of the board to add for some stiffener at the end. And there'll be a small framework as well to enclose it all in. As you can see, the ESU colour command system is set up. No power yet, because I've not plugged it in. We have the Woodland Scenic servicing track doodah there. Track tidy, or tidy track even. Got a bit of mess on it. Going to have to peel out the Velcro strips to clean them off. As you can see, we've got a Class 128 Parcels DMU, again a Heljan model. I decided to add the track so that when at exhibition we have the single car parcels unit travelling as a through service, and then when the bubble car becomes available, I may get one of those if I've got a job to pay for it, to add as a passenger through service. Another idea was to basically add another add another section on there as a drop-in loading cartridge. There you go, loading cartridge, so I can actually run bigger trains at exhibition. But I'll think about that again at a later date. So we'll come to the station area. Again, nothing's happened much there. I did move the building from there over slightly to here and move the bus stop onto that corner, and then decided it looked a bit odd, bearing in mind that the platform's there and there's supposed to be elevators to go down. If you're ever wondering how do you get passengers in there onto the platform? Well, this is a lift section there, and it goes down. There's a pedestrian walkway underneath, and then when we come in underneath, you can see the staircase well there. There isn't actually any staircases in there because I actually forgot to fit them. So, bit of a boo-boo there, but never mind. It's back into focus. On board three, not touched it at all. I will be starting to cover this in the next couple of days, because on board two, it's still looking a bit dirty at the moment. Sorry, dirty, wet, gluey, sticky. That's because I've literally just finished that. I did find out, in fact, on the previous video, there was a gap there. That was because when I fitted the viaduct stroke bridge, you can see the gap. What happened is when I actually aligned it to the board, I had this had another wall on this side. And when I pushed the two boards together, I forgot that, you know, there would be a space difference. So there's a bit of a major cock up. Rather than try and remove the viaduct off the board because it's super glued down, if I did that, I'd probably end up cracking it because it's an original Hornby one made in England, which are quite rare to get hold of nowadays in good condition. I've decided to use a strip of architectural board instead. And then the card sheet itself is glued quite heavily on there. And underneath, there's a strip of plastic which was super glued to the existing roadway to raise it to a bit more flat. So that's looking quite messy, but by the time the glue's set, and then I've put some weathering powder on there and then sprayed some varnish on it, it'll look the bee's knees with any luck if I don't cock it up. And essentially, that's all what's happened in the past couple of weeks. So, as always, enjoy your model making where you are in the world, and we'll catch up with you again in a few more weeks' time with hopefully a bit more done. Goodbye now.